Hello, everybody. It's been revealed what's behind the hangar doors is Operation Summer. I'm apologizing right now that I missed the news right away. My plan was to stay up and actually cover the news right when it was released. Unfortunately, my stupidity caused me to maybe fall asleep a little bit. Sorry about that. Big time sorry about that. But I'm still going to cover it either way, and it looks like it's Operation Summer. A not really summertime madness, but a cool-looking event either way. Now, I haven't really read through it all, so for all I know, it's going to fuck me in the face. But there are a lot of bonuses up for grabs. A lot of 3D decals, which gave me a boner. Pin-up decals. New vehicles, exclusive vehicles, which annoys me and also gives me a boner. So, I cannot wait to read through this, and because my eyes are a little bit weird and watery, I want to apologize. Oh yes, and my voice. So, Operation Summer, here we go. It starts today. Oh, fuck. Well, so much for my plans that I made for No Man's Sky. August 22nd, it goes until then? Are you kidding me? Holy shit. Okay, whatever, let's just pretend like... Oh my god. Okay. So, inside the hangar was testing Ground 113, which did not hold the TU-95, unfortunately. It did not hold some special ship, unfortunately. Instead, it held 4 special testing vehicles. Which I guess is pretty cool. Anyways, as it says, Pilots and Tankers, the last month of summer will be a month to remember. We're announcing the start of a big new event, Operation SUMMER. 4 new premium vehicles straight from the testing grounds, new decals, and other prizes for the best warriors in the skies and on the ground. Now, it says best warriors, which makes me afraid because I feel like maybe it'll be tournaments. Oh, let's open up the calendar. What am I looking at right now? Oh my god, what the hell am I looking at right now? I don't even realize, I don't even understand. What are all these little pictures? Hello?
Hello?
Are these like the tasks? Okay, let me just... I just woke up, don't blame me. Terms and conditions, tasks and change... Or tasks are changed every day at 11 GMT. Weekend tasks are changed on Monday at the same time. The special is divided for pilots and tankers. A player may complete both ground and air tasks to get all rewards. Boing. All respected vehicles of rank 3 to 5 can be used for the completion of the tasks. Okay, skipped tasks may be purchased in the item shop for the day they appear. Tasks may be changed at the discretion of the administration. Okay. Click on the day in the calendar to see more. Okay, so like Monday, which would be the first day. Right. Yeah, from 22nd to 24th. Well, what is today? Today is Friday, so why does it say Monday? I don't know, whatever. If it's from the 22nd to the 24th, it looks like we've got 4 different tasks here. Yeah, that's what it says. Saturday and Sunday. Oh yeah, 22 to 24 and then 25, 26. Yeah, okay. So there's 4 tasks for both air and ground, and these are what they are. Okay, well let's not look at these yet because it doesn't look like... No, it doesn't look like tournaments. Oh my god, okay. It looks like it's going to be a pain in the fucking ass task event. Oh god, okay. Okay, let's just read the main page and look at what some of the prizes are. The military arts never stop changing. Somewhere on the front line, shells are firing and turrets are torn off turret rings. Off to the side, engineers strive night and day to perfect their fighting machines. New engines and weapons are developed and armor is strengthened. The results of their efforts are now perfectly tangible. And here are the four vehicles, guys, that you can earn. Vehicles from Testing Ground 113 include the FW-189 Yoohoo, or whatever it's, however it's pronounced, the Grant Mark I, the F7F3 Tiger Cat, and the KV-220. Oh my god. Well, shit. And they also have military camouflages, if that's what this means. Military camouflages are also available for all Testing Ground 113 vehicles presented here. Now, you can read these. Like, does this just take me to the... No, it actually takes me to its own page. It doesn't just take me to the dev blog. Yeah, look at this. It actually takes me to its own page, guys. This is pretty cool. Okay, let me pause that video. Let's look at the FW-189. So this is a plane that was announced months ago. Months. This was announced, like, way the frick back when I was playing Mad Max. And it's finally here. Like, holy shit, they announced this way ahead of time. And now we finally got it. A lot of people were hoping that this was behind the hangar doors. Well, here you go. You got what you wanted. Let's take a look at exactly what this plane entails. The FW-189 Uhu, or whatever, from testing, has a different skin material in the engine unit, controllers, and many internal improvements compared to original machine. The characteristics and performance are the same, though. All of the components have been reconditioned and all available modifications have been installed. The vehicle has a premium status. That's great. Here's information about it. Okay, so it'll be for Germany, of course. The battle rating will be 1.7. 1.7, I'm assuming that means it's 1.7 in both arcade and realistic. It's a rank 1. Its climb rate is shit. The max speed is shit. No, it's actually pretty good. Offensive armament is... It looks like you've got... Oh, you've got two defensive 7.92mm machine guns and two... offensive 7.92mm machine guns. So you'll be able to shoot two of them and you'll have a gunner. Or two gunners. In fact, right there. And right there. And then here you can read on the history. I'm not going to read that. You can read that if you want. So this is one of the prizes right here. The FW-189. Which is fan-dabaduthi. Now the Grant Mark 1. I'm a little interested in this. Is this a different Grant Mark 1? Because... The Grant Mark 1 isn't such... I mean, it's an exclusive for the United States, but you can buy it on Steam. There's not much, Well, let's see. What is the Grant Mark 1 for? Doesn't look like that in the game, I know that much. Okay, anyways. No, it doesn't. It does not have that camouflage. Maybe this isn't for the United States. Maybe this is the British one. Hold on a minute. Let me go back once here. I think it showed another thing down here. Yeah, it said, get a pinup decal by completing of tasks for pilot. Or for pilot. So if you complete the tasks for the 189, I believe, you also get this pinup decal, which is of a lovely-looking German lady there. At least she doesn't have her ass turned around, because, you know, that's usually what you'd expect. And it looks like, here's one of them, oh shit, get a little of this. Get the 3D decoration, the Sten gun, by completing the tanker tasks, guys. They've added new guns, new 3D guns. It's not just the PPSH anymore. Each nation now has one, I think. But look, the 3D Sten gun. Yes. Oh, I love 3D guns. I'm going to have an arsenal of weaponry on my one tank. Actually, no, I'm not, because I like to have some other things on there. Okay, let's see exactly what this Grant 1 is for. It's for Britain. It is for Britain, guys. They are getting their... I just did a Talking War Thunder video about British having their own exclusive Grant Mark 1 or Premium 1. And here it is. They have an exclusive Grant 1. Okay, I was going to say, it doesn't make sense to do one for the United States, because you can buy that one on Steam. So you can't get it in the game anymore, but if you want it, you have to go through Steam to buy it. So this is cool. This is an actual British premium now. That is great. Okay, let's read about what the Grant 1 has to offer. So the Grant Mark 1, the Grant Mark 1 from Testing Ground 113 is different to the M3 Lee and has many improvements. The most noticeable is the new cast steel turret with a 37mm M5 cannon. The commander's cupola has been removed, and along with a lower profile new turret which affected the tank's height, making it smaller. The tank has been re-equipped for desert conditions. Improved air filters have been installed. The machine has high reload speed for both guns, which provides intense fire whilst the cannon's characteristics allow it to inflict serious damage on all of its opponents. The vehicle was tested and upgraded, which guaranteed the reliability or the reliable operation of all components. The tank has all available modifications installed and has a premium status. So once you complete the tasks, you will get a Sten gun, and it's for AB and RB. Country, it's for Britain. Battle rating 2.7 for both game modes. Rank 2. Hull armor is shit. Who cares about the hull armor? I mean, if you want to look at that, you can. Max speed, 43 miles per hour, 39 kilometers an hour. Or no, that's 43 kilometers an hour in arcade, 39 kilometers an hour in realistic. And the main gun penetration value at 500 meters is 69 millimeters of penetration. So there you go, guys. The Grant Mark 1 for the British. Oh my god, I'm starting to sweat. I am starting to sweat. So basically, these are like the first ones that you'll earn. So this is like, let's close that. This is like the first aircraft task that you'll get, or the first aircraft reward you'll get, and then the first ground forces reward, and then you get a second even better one. So let's look at the second better aviation one, the F7F3 Tiger Cat. Now, I love the Tiger Cat, but I can't fly it for shit, so, you know. Let's see. The F7F3 Tiger Cat from Testing Ground 113 is further development of the U.S. Navy twin-engine fighter, the F7F. The third modification is equipped with more powerful engines, which allowed for the installation of unguided rockets and even three tiny TIMs, which are annoying. Oh my god, look at the size of those rockets! Did you see that? Holy shit! Look at that! Look at that! Holy shit! I do not want to be in a tank when they're firing off those things. Anyways, which were effective not only against ships, but also enemy bases. Although the... I wonder why. Although the original F7F could reach a very high speed for a twin-engine fighter, this new machine accelerates even faster both in level flight and in a dive, which makes it an excellent aircraft for hit-and-run tactics. Like the original Tiger Cat... The F7F3 has four 20mm guns, ANM2, and four 12.7mm machine guns, Browning M2s, a powerful arsenal with a fire rate of almost 8 kilograms of lead per second. After testing, some of the experimental markings have been left behind, and some of the surfaces and engines are on some of the surfaces and engines. The aircraft is fully equipped with all the latest modifications and has a premium status. That is fantastic. Look at that. It's like purple. Oh, God, guys. I've got to say, this one gives me a booner. So for this one, it looks like you get another pinup decal, which is of a lovely United States lady with the United States flag in the background. The information on this is the country is, of course, the United States of America. The battle rating is 6.7 in arcade, 6.0 in realistic battles. Rank 4, rate of climb is good. Max speed is good. Very good, actually. Or no, that's kilometers an hour. It's good. Offensive armament is, well, just what we just said, 420mm and 450-caliber machine gun. So maybe I could start to learn to fly the F7F a little better, but I usually suck at it. But I definitely would love to add this to my collection, without a doubt. And we've got some other camouflages here, actually. That one looks really cool. And the other one, guys, the big ground forces one. Ooh, let's look at this, baby. Holy shit. Oh, God. The KV-220, or what I'm assuming is going to be called the KV-220. The KV-220 from Testing Ground 113, a unique vehicle which is going through comprehensive testing and is not part of the series of prototypes, a further development of the KV-1 Soviet tank. The KV-220 is superior to its predecessor in every way. The tank has thicker 100mm frontal armor, okay, that gives me a boner, and a long-barreled F-30 85mm gun, that gives me a boner. Also, the engine is more powerful. As you can see, it's moving awful fast in the video here. The tank has passed the complete cycle of testing and is battle ready. It has been upgraded with all necessary modifications, which saves time in which the crew would take to bring to it to an ideal operating condition, and its premium status will seriously increase the income of battle. And look, you get the PPS 43. You get another Russian one. So now the Russians have two 3D decals in the game, but I don't give a shit because the PPSH and PPS 43 are beautiful weapons. Information, tactical, and technical characteristics, A, B, and RB. It is the country of the USSR, of course. The battle rating is 5.3 in both game modes. Rank 3. Hull armor is 100 all around, and turret armor is 100 all around. Maximum speed, 36 kilometers an hour in arcade, 34 kilometers an hour in realistic. That is pretty damn slow. 123 millimeters on the main gun penetration at a value at 500 meters. Whew. I've got to say, guys, I'm looking forward to all of these. I'm very excited that the Grant 1 is a British premium. So the Germans get something, the British get something, the United States get something, and the Russians get something. Poor Japanese. So I think that's really, really cool. It's kind of weird. Why don't the Japanese get, like, a plane? I mean, I'm not going to sit here and complain, but, I mean, it's kind of weird. You know, the Germans get a plane, but they don't get a tank. The British get a tank, but they don't get a plane. The United States get a plane, but they don't get a tank. The Russians get a tank, but they don't get a plane. Wouldn't you think that the Japanese would at least get a new plane? An exclusive plane? They have, like, one exclusive vehicle in the entire game. You would think that the Japanese, with how crazy of their prototype designs they would have like a million exclusives. But, whatever. Sorry, Japanese players, there's nothing here for you. Which is quite unfortunate. We're not done just yet, though. How to participate, Operation Summer, or SUU, or SUMMER, will take place from July 22nd to August 22nd. Every day, pilots and tankers will receive tasks to get marks of distinction, completing which will guarantee participants new 3D decorations, which is awesome, decals, discounts, and other bonuses, which is awesome. The most active participants will become owners of the unique premium vehicles from Testing Ground 3 or 113. If you missed the marks of distinction, each task will be available for one day and will be changed to another after 24 hours. Each weekend player, so you have to buy it, but if you miss it, then you're not going to get it, unless they do it again at like the very end. Each weekend players will have 4 tasks for pilots and tankers and can be completed within the 2 days. The marks of distinction, which is air and ground, can still be obtained with Golden Eagles at any time during the event from the day that they appeared. Future marks are not available until they are released. Oh, okay, well, whatever. And then here's the calendar if you want to go and view that. Yeah, look at this, guys. The Thompson! I didn't look at these! The Thompson is available! I saw the MP40, the Sten, and the PPS-43, but I didn't see the Thompson. Holy shit! Oh, that is awesome! I want the Kar-98, please, not the MP40. Whatever. They're all submachine guns and machine guns, so I guess we'll just have to deal with what we've got. Main prize, testing range. Okay, here's what you need. If you want the German FW-189, you have to complete 18 pilot marks of distinctions, or 18 tasks. And if you want the British Grant Mark 1, you need to complete 18 ground tasks. If you want the US F7-F3 Tiger Cat, you have to complete 36 air tasks. And if you want the Soviet KV-220, you have to complete 36 ground tasks. So you've got a lot of shit to do. At least it's equal. At least it's 18 and 18 and 36 and 36. Usually they're not so equal. And they look hard as hell. Anyways, it says every 10 obtained tanker marks of distinction will reward you with these. Which is weird, because the KV-222 said that you'll get the PPS-43. But if I was to complete 10 of these, maybe I'd get one random or something. I don't know, but hopefully you can get your hands on all of them. Because it said every 10, then you'd have to complete 40 of these, and there's only 36. I'm so confused on that. That's a bit confusing. And every 8 obtained pilot marks of distinction will reward you with these. There's one for each nation. There's even a Japanese one, but they're not in the event. you got the Soviet one and the British one there. If I had to pick what one out of here looks the loveliest, I'm not going to say, because then people will hate me. Every four tanker marks of distinction. Holy shit. Okay, so here's what you can get. So every four, you get a special trophy. What you can get out of them include 50 to 500,000 Silver Lions, which is pretty good. 50 to 200% boosters for Silver Lions and RP. That's really good. 50 to 200%. You got to be lucky that you're not getting 10% boosters. Talisman for rank 2 to 4 tanks. I love that. Random tank camo. I love that. And 30 to 50% discount for random premium tank. I will not use the 30% discount, but if I get a 50% discount, I will use it. Every 4 pilot marks of distinction, you get the same exact stuff, only you get the talisman for the aircraft, random aircraft camo, 30 to 50% discount on random premium aircraft, so it's the same exact thing, just for aircraft. And then the terms and terms and conditions are, tasks are changed every day at 11 GMT. Weekend tasks are changed on Monday at the same time. The special is divided for pilots and tankers. A player may complete both tank and air tasks to get all the rewards, which is great if you have, you know, the balls. All respective vehicles and of ranks 3 to 5 can be used for the completion of the tasks. Skipped tasks may be purchased in the item shop from the day they appear. Tasks may be changed at the... we've already read through those, actually, haven't we? and then your questions. Okay, so, yeah, we know about that one. Yeah, we know about that one. No, well, it says there will be multipliers. Okay, if I get a... No, it says, okay, yeah, so that's people wanting to know if you get the same exact shit over and over again. Ew, gross. So let's take a look at the calendar then again, and let's just look at what we have to do for today. So we're looking at the 22nd to the 24th. So we've got we need to complete 8 tasks in the next 2 days. Holy shit, if you want to get everything. And that includes war in midair. Oh no. Wait, why does it say AI controlled targets? War in midair. What is war in midair? Is that the one where you have to shoot down planes with SPAA? Because I fucking hate that event so much. I guess, I don't know. But I have to destroy 50 ground AI targets. But it doesn't say that there's a times 2 for RB. It says that there's a times 2 for RB for destroy 25 player-controlled aircraft in random battles. So I guess some of them are different, some of them are not. Okay, so for air, you have to destroy 50 ground-to-AI-controlled targets in war in mid-air event. Then the second task is to destroy 25 player-controlled aircraft in random battles. That's times 2 for RB and times 3 for SB. Gain 15 assists in random battles. You know, when you need to get assists, it doesn't work. And then also gain fighter rescuer or bomber rescuer achievement 5 times in random battles. God damn, are you serious? Oh god, it's going to be like this. It's going to be where they want these very particular things. Destroy 50 aircraft in war in midair event for ground forces. Take first place on the leaderboard of a random battle 3 times. Oh no, we've only just started, Gaijin. Don't do this. Holy crap, man, I hate that so much. I hate having to try and get first place, because then everybody's trying to do it, and then it's hardened as ass. Receive the achievement Teamwork 25 times! Holy shit! Destroy 40 tanks in random battles. Yeah, see, that's not too bad. Well, it looks like I'm going to have to be returning to ground forces for this, which is a bit annoying, but at the same time, hey, special vehicles. So you can go ahead and take a look here on the calendar yourself to look at all of the different things. Let's just take a look at some random day. The 19th of August, you have to gain Teamwork Award in random battles 7 times. That's not as bad as today. And destroy 40 tanks in random battles. That's not as bad as today either. I mean, that's exactly the same. Whatever. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder video.